Welcome to PyMOL 101 with Molecular Memory. In this lesson, we'll learn about the different PyMOL input and output file types and how to export a publication quality image. In the last part, we'll learn to work with scenes, one of the best ways to save work and time. Let's go. We'll start in the RCSB PDB with the structure of carbonic anhydrase from the previous lesson, PDB ID 3UYN. Given the beautiful, complex-looking structures we've seen in the first two lessons, you might be surprised to learn that the input file type is simply a text file. The original files were .pdb, but a new file type called CIF has replaced that. The details of how these files differ is really important to a structural biologist, but a little beyond my scope. If you're interested in these nuances, though, check out the video description for a link to this PDB 101 page explaining them. From the RCSB PDB page, let's view the CIF file for the structure. We've got some general information about the citation first, some structural information that PyMOL reads to set up the cartoon renderings, and near the end, the file gives information about the 3D coordinates of each atom in every residue of the structure. That's all PyMOL needs to create great images. We're going to use the file we saved in lesson 2. If you didn't work through that episode, pause this video, go to the video description, and copy the command line code at the end. Paste that into the command line, press enter, and you'll be all caught up. Now save using the drop-down file menu or by pressing Ctrl S on your keyboard. This saves a PyMOL session file with a .pse at the end of the file name. PSE files open in PyMOL and can be shared with others helping you create images. Speaking of images, PyMOL exports PNG image files. To prep this structure for a publication quality image, we'll first change the background. In the drop-down menu, Display, Background, White. The color white is preferred because manuscripts have a white background, and the image appears to float against it. Black backgrounds also take a lot of printer ink, so back in the day when we printed everything, it was very important to avoid black. This next part is tricky. Reposition the image and try to show each and every active site sidechain clearly. We don't want any hidden behind anything else, and we want to avoid an edge-on view, like how we can't see this tryptophan sidechain here clearly. The clipping we learned about in Lesson 1 can be helpful. Scroll two fingers up and down on the trackpad to adjust, or use a scroll wheel on a mouse. Now, cut-off cartoon renderings look pretty bad too, so this part takes time to get just right. Okay, I think this is the best I can do with this structure. Now it's time to save the PNG. We can use the file menu, export image as, PNG, and I get some options to choose from. But the way I normally save is using the external GUI buttons at the top right. Click draw/ray, and you can adjust the PNG to be as small or as large as you need. If you have the option to ray, this will add a transparent background and make a very sharp image. It gives some additional depth and makes it look like there's a light shining on the structure. This creates shadows, like we see right here, which may not be preferred since there's, well, actually no spotlight within a cell. Whether you choose to draw or ray here, you'll get the option to save the PNG or copy the image directly to the clipboard, which I find very useful. Not to be dramatic, but the day I learned to save scenes revolutionized my PyMOL modeling experience. It is so easy to misclick and mess up your structure, and scenes give you a quick and easy way to go back. Every time I like the way a structure looks while I'm modeling, I save a scene. Go to the drop-down Scene menu, Store, select F1. The scene appears in the bottom left of the Structure Viewer window. Right-click and rename to give your scene a more memorable name. The old scene name appears in the upper left-hand side of the Structure Viewer window. Delete that, and let's call this Active Site. Now, if you make a small adjustment to the structure and you want to update the Active Site scene, right-click and choose Update. Let's change the whole rendering to see how scenes work. Next to 3UIN in the Names panel, Action button, A, Zoom. This zooms out to show the entire protein. Now S button, Show as Surface. Rotate the protein and reorient it a little bit. Let's color it a solid color. Now save a scene. Scene dropdown, Store, F1. Right-click on F1 to rename it to Surface, or whatever you want. Now, left-click on the two scene names to toggle between them. Neat! You can always return to the exact view from any scene you've saved. Don't forget to Control-S now and save your whole PSE session file with the new scenes within it. Thanks for watching this episode of PyMOL 101. Feel free to leave me a comment or a question, and if you're enjoying this series, subscribe to my channel. Happy modeling!